Hey guys, it's Tomation. Welcome back to some more Cave Story. In the last episode, we escaped from prison, and we helped Sue's mother build a rocket to take us up to the Doctor's throne. However, we still need to restore our friend's memory here. So, according to Cthulhu here, we have to go find a special mushroom to restore her memory. Da-di-da-di-da-di, saying the same thing over again. So, thankfully, we know where to find a special discolored mushroom. It's time to head back to Omega Village. But thankfully, now that we've been sent to prison once, the Drawl and the teleporter room will not be there anymore. And I fell into the water. Amazing jumping skills. So the path is clear this time for us to actually teleport. Professor Booster is still here inside of Arthur's house. He doesn't seem to want to escape. He's going to start a new life here in Omega Village, just inside of Arthur's house, all by himself. Alrighty. So now with that final life capsule from Steve, our life bar is now at complete 50 health. And that's the highest life you're ever going to get in Cave Story. Back to the graveyard, I think it's finally about time we go fight that special mushroom. Let me up. Hello there, Blue Mushroom. You got the business with me? This time, we do. Amnesia. How awful. Well then, do you want me to give you the mushroom badge? Yes? But in reality, you don't really want it, right? Well, no. You want it that much? No. Yeah, who needs it? So, he's sort of trying to confuse you here. You don't really want it. But we do want it that much. But not really. I actually don't know the answers to this. They changed it in this version. No. Yes. Yes. No. There we go. And we get the mushroom badge. The 8th gym leader in all of Cave Story, Ma Pignon. But if we leave the room here, and we investigate it, the mushroom badge you got from the mushroom has no real use, to be honest. You don't really need it. Ha ha, found me out, eh? That's nothing more than the silly badge. My gym badge! What? You wanna eat me? I'll have you know that I'm a valuable, valuable mushroom like no other in all caves. Grr. I'm not just gonna let you eat me up. Die! So, we actually have to fight this little mushroom. This is Ma Pignon. When he charges across the screen like that, he'll rain a bunch of boulders down from the ceiling. He can also create clones of himself. This isn't too hard of a boss fight. Alright, when he runs across the screen like that, normally he'll send out a bunch of fake versions of himself raining down from the ceiling. Find the real one and keep shooting at it. There we go. As you'd probably expect from his small size, he doesn't have that much health. You win! And we literally pick up the boss itself. We get Ma Pignon. So, we have to go feed that to Curly now in order to bring her memory back. I have to worry about all these normal Pignons. I just realized the Gravekeeper in here kind of looks like a Drawl, just weaker. Alrighty. Back to the plantation we go. Alright, and we can now teleport back to the plantation, so we have all 5 teleportable areas unlocked now as well. So for whatever reason, if we need to backtrack to any of them, we can. Back in the plantation. We're going across the spring, or the spring one more time. To deliver a shroom to Crowley. Dinner's here. Who are you? Do you want to use the Ma Pignon? Jammed it into Curly's mouth. Yeah. Less said about that, the better. Quote. I remember now. Your name's Quote. You and I. Right. Back then, a huge number of robots were sent to this island. from countries on the Earth's surface. Their target was the awesome power kept within this island, the Demon Crown. But you and I, we were different. The two of us were sent in order to destroy that power. When we got here, the island was in shambles. The robots had torn it all to pieces, and countless Amigas had been slaughtered. It was terrible. Finally, one man got the Demon Crown in his possession. The robot's work was done, and the island fell silent. But that was just the beginning of the tragedy. With the crown in hand, the man turned the Amigas into killers and began his assault on the Earth. I tried to stop him. You were there, too. That's as far as I can remember. I'm pretty sure we were able to wound him. But we seemed far out in our league. Do you remember anything? Alright, so Curly seemed to have gotten all of her memories back. I'm fine, thank you. Don't worry about me. Oh, here. Take this with you. And Curly gives us the Iron Bond. I'm fine now. Alright, the Iron Bond, you're tied to Curly Brace, the only warrior you should trust your back to. Surely, you two will meet again one day. Alright, so the Iron Bond, we can now carry on up going up to the Doctor's Throne. Oh hey look, the rocket ship respawned. How convenient. Flip the switch and ride this thing way up. Yeah, needless to say, the booster would not be able to ascend you high or fast enough to get past all of them. Save your game? Oh god. Here we go. I'm gonna end the recording real quick because I have a feeling that this area is probably gonna kill me at least once or twice, so be back in a second. Alright, let's give this another try. You feel a black wind blow for you. All weapons drop to level 1. Welcome to the last cave. We start off in the first cave, now we're in the last cave. If you have the booster version 2.0 and the Iron Bond in your inventory, the last cave will look like this. Cave story access free endings, there's 2 bad endings and 1 good ending. If you're going for the second bad ending, this area will be a lot easier. However, since I'm going for the best ending you can possibly get, this area will be really rough on me. You've already seen all the enemies in this area before, however now they're different colors and they do more damage to you. We have critters who we're seeing again, and bats will start showing up later. So basically, all the enemies you saw in the first cave, recolored and made more dangerous. Now you might notice this yellow life capsule looking thing up here. This is actually an experience capsule. When you break it, it'll drop experience for you. Which is rather useful, considering, as you saw at the start there, when you enter this area, all your weapons drop down to level 1. These spikes in lava, as you saw there, are an instant kill, however they do quite a lot of damage to you, which starts adding up once you start ramming your face into them all. It'd probably be a good idea to start breaking all the experience capsules along the way and leveling up your weapons, but I'm more concerned about just getting out of this place alive. So the bats, as you can see here, work a little bit differently than they used to. Now they sort of just fly across the screen and keep respawning. So the last cave likes to force you to use the booster in some awkward positions or to dodge spikes. It gets more apparent later on. Coming up right about now, actually. Yeah, there we go. They gave you a jetpack, they want you to use it. Right now here, this critter will try and jump on your head, so float your way up there, kill him, then go back up. And we seem to have a red droll over there. This is the red demon. Do you remember that demon that Jack in the movie Gavillage was telling us about? This is him. Unfortunately for him, he's sort of just a glorified droll. His attacks are the exact same, his jump patterns are the same. Only difference is he can now fire free shots of the axe things, and he can now just jump straight up. When you kill him, he made that sort of shocked surprise face, which I always find amusing. And he drops you a treasure chest, which contains the clay figure medal. Similar to the mushroom badge, it doesn't really do anything. Small and profoundly heavy, it has no use. That's just sort of to verify that you beat the red demon. The dripping lava from the ceiling isn't too hard to avoid, you can sort of run under it easily enough. I'm actually pretty sure the critters in this area jump farther than the old ones do. here's where the painful part of this area comes. These are presses. As you've seen them before, however, now we have to run underneath them and fire a really quick spur up. If you don't have the spur, you have to run underneath them, then jump, then run. You have to run underneath them so they set them off, then jump back and then shoot them like that. Either way, this is a very difficult passage to go through. If you level up the bubbler to level 3, you can sort of just stand here and sort of make the shield come up and hit them like that. Unfortunately, I don't have that luxury. Laser beam, save me. You may be asking yourself, why don't you just run underneath them? That works for a little bit. Unfortunately, when you get to that point up there where the lava is, they start crushing down faster and you can really run underneath them. So I prefer to go this safe way. There we go. Alright, if I just break this one, I can take care of all the ones on this line. Boom, there we go. Alright. Now a few well-positioned spurs should be able to get me through these. Last one. There we go. Alright. Two more red critters hop out of that lava pit. And we are out of here. And we've reached the balcony. There's an angel statue up here, which you can't really do much with. And, hey look! We have some more Raybills that we saw in Grasstown, which we now know are frenzied Mimigas. There's also a helicopter here, presumably the one that Sue, Professor Booster, and all them arrived on the island with. There's a house here. Prefab building. There's a bed which we can use to restore our health, which is convenient. Also a save machine, which you should probably use. Alright. So up here we have another Raybill and Igor. So now we also learn that Igor from the Egg Quarter was another frenzied Mimiga. Fortunately for us, this one has... Actually, wait, unfortunately for us, I'm actually pretty sure this one has more health than the Igor did in the Egg Quarter. And he also fires shots more rapidly. So it basically made you fight another boss up here. Igor has now been demoted to mini-boss. Anyway, before you enter there, climb up the side here. If you didn't level up one of your weapons, or you didn't finish leveling one of them up inside the final cave, up here, there are a load of hearts for you to restore your life, a ton of experience capsules, and missiles to restore your missile launcher with. This is a very easy way to level up all the weapons. And also why I wasn't too concerned about leveling them all up in the final cave. You can just use these to level them all up. And when you've gotten all the experience from them, you can just re-enter the prefab building and carry on breaking them. So I'll see you when I've leveled up all my weapons to level 3. Alright, I leveled up most of my weapons to level 3, aside from the missile launcher, which I can level up at the start of next episode. Because we're running this episode off now. Next time in Cave Story, we'll be entering the Firm Room and facing off against the Doctor. So